Hey folks, Brian Netter from Summit Racing here. Today we're going to talk a little bit about the differences between the Generation 3 and the Generation 4 LS engines. Why is that important? What are the differences? Well, there were different displacements. You had 4.8s, 5.3s, 5.7s, 6.0s, 6.2, and 7-liter. You had different block materials. You had iron, you had aluminum, most of them with aluminum cylinder heads. The Gen 3s were pretty stable in terms of the technologies. Each engine had their purpose. The Gen 4s, GM engineers went a little crazy with it, and they mixed up the attributes all over the place. So all told, you actually have 46 different RPO codes between the Gen 3 and Gen 4 engines. We're going to cover a little bit about how to identify those today. It's important to note that the Gen 3 engines were made between 1997 up through 2007. Some of the Gen 4s started off a little earlier, as early as 2005. And so right there in that 2005 to 2007 time span, you had some interesting mix of, you know, the 24X ECM, 58X, et cetera. Also interesting to note that while the Gen 5 engines, you know, really started hitting around that 14-15 timeframe, Gen 4 engines are actually still being used. In particular, one of the 4.8 liter engines is being used in commercial van duty, and it's just going to keep on soldiering on. So we'll go through them and how to identify them here today, and we'll start off with a few things that you'll always find in a Gen 3, a few things that you'll always find in a Gen 4 or maybe. And just we'll give you some guides too. Summit Racing has published a number of guides to help you sort by VIN, by the technologies, how to identify pictures. We're going to start off with Gen 3. That's the one that came out in 1997, was used in the trucks by 1999 going forward. Those were available in 4.8s, 5.3s, 5.7s, 6.0s. The 5.7s were the ones used in the car. That was the almighty LS one that really started everything, and the other ones were considered Vortec truck engines. The blocks could be had in iron or aluminum in the trucks. Obviously, the LS ones used in the F-body Camaro Firebird, and then the Y-body Corvette LS ones, those were all aluminum blocks. Another thing that you'd find common amongst them is cathedral port heads. Cathedral ports were used on all the Gen 3s and many of the Gen 4s, but if you ever find a rectangle port anything, it's not a Gen 3 engine unless somebody's backdated it. This one, Gen 3, one of the easy ways to spot a Gen 3 is it's got the knock sensors in the valley, as opposed to the Gen 4s where these knock sensors were actually moved down to the sides of the oil pan here. Why was it that the move was made with Gen 4? It's because some of those engines were equipped with AFM, and that has a different structure internally for oil passages. The valley cover is completely different, so those knock sensors had to be moved around. The other thing with the Gen 3 is you'll find that the cam sensor is in the back on these engines, as opposed to Gen 4 where that's actually moved to the front cover. Another thing you can count on is they didn't have AFM or VVT, so they're all 3-bolt cams. They're all 24X. Something to note about that crank, that reluctor wheel. Gen 3s, as we spoke, you know, those were actually available up through about 2007, and the Gen 4s actually started at 2005, so there was a little bit of overlap there. And there were times where Gen 4 engines, like the LS2, for instance, using the GTO and the Corvette, would actually use a 24X reluctor ring, and that's the older style computer. The exception to that is the LQ4. In the first couple of years, it had the original small block Chevy, a relatively thick rear flange. That was in 99 and 2000. By 2001, it had gone with the later model flange, you know, the thinner flange that's found on basically all the rest of the Gen 3s and 4s, you know, going up through 2007 in particular on the LQ4. Basically everything going forward of that, including all of the automotive engines, were, you know, what we know as the thinner LS flange going through the rest of the Gen 3 families and the Gen 4s. In 1997, the Corvette came out with a drive-by-wire throttle body. This helped its stability control, the traction control, etc. The trucks all came with mechanical cable throttle bodies. In about 2003 or so, they were able to go ahead and introduce the drive-by-wire on some of the trucks that had traction control. F-bodies, Camaros, and Firebirds also had throttle by cable as well. So that's one thing that you can take a look at. We'll get into some of the Gen 4 differences, similarities, and go forward from there. So we'll speak a little bit about the fourth gen engines. Started coming out roughly 2005. You can find iron blocks in 5.3 or 6 liter displacements. The aluminum blocks you'll find in either a 5.3, a 6 liter, 6.2, or 7 liter displacement. Cathedral ports and rectangle ports and the LS7 were all used on Gen 4 engines. Cathedrals could be found on the trucks. Engines like the LS3 and L92, that was, you know, what was called the rectangle port, and those could be found on cars and trucks, 6 liters and 6.2s. Of course, there's the almighty LS7 with its own bespoke cylinder head. So you could find multiple different types of cylinder heads on those. These engines came with AFM or not, active fuel management. So the valley cover might be flat if it wasn't equipped with that, or it might have the ribbed assembly, and we'll get you some close-ups of both of those so you can, you know, plainly see the difference. I mean, it's night and day difference on that. The cam sensor moved to the front of the engine. It's on the front timing cover now at this point. Another thing you might find on the front timing cover if the engine was equipped with VVT is the solenoid that runs the phaser assembly itself. The Gen 4 engines were also equipped with 58X reluctor rings. And that would mean that it used either a one single bolt or a three bolt, four pole upper gear. The exception of that was the 2005 Corvette with its LS2 that used a 24X reluctor. The 2005 and 6 GTO also used the LS2. And then there was the LS4 and the LR4 5.3s. Around 2005 that were still 24X. After that, everything was converted out to 58X. AFM and VVT, all of the AFM and the VVT engines will, you know, basically have the single bolt front cam, with the exception of the LS7 used in the Camaro Z28, the fifth gen, and like a Z06, for instance. Also the LS3 used in the 2010 to 2013 C6 Grand Sport, and I believe the ZR1, the LS9 used in the ZR1 all use 3-volt cams as well. All the cranks use, basically whether it's a Gen 3 or 4, we're going to be a 6-volt rear flange. The exception to that would be the LS8 used in the CTSV with an 8-volt crank, and then the LS9 used in the ZR1 that had a 9-volt rear flange. Oiling, almost all the engines were wet-sup engines. The exception to that would have been the LS3 Grand Sport, the LS7 powered C6Z, the 5th Gen Camaro Z28, and the ZR1. All those received a dry sump system. 2010, those actually had an upgraded tank in there for more oil capacity. Again, you know, Summit Racing has been putting this information together for you. We'll have links down below this video. Be sure to like and subscribe to get more of our how-to videos, the technical videos, and installation videos. Thank you for watching.